Hi everyone, it's Mrs. Fortunato again, and Daniel.
Hi.
We're going to finish our reading segment of Bob by reading chapter 18. This one's called Bob. Did anyone else just see a chicken shimmy down that drain pipe? One of the big-headed boys had shouted. It had something rolled up under its wing. Maybe it's a wombat, his friend or brother had suggested. This was no wombat. The woman with them swatted them on the heads and told them, said not to tell tales. It was epic. I wait for Livy to join me behind the tree. Wait till you hear what I've learned, I say when she finally arrives, huffing and puffing. She puts up a give me a minute finger, then she takes out a whistle and blows hard into it twice. I put my hands over my ears. Ouch! Finely tuned sense of sound, remember? Sorry, I have to blow it every 2 minutes. We hear two more whistle blows close by, but less painful. Livy smiles. That's grand. She's resting. She twists around, likely making sure we're alone before asking, what are you doing here, Bob? After you left me without saying anything, even though you know I'm sensitive about that. I pause as she reaches out to pat me on the head, a gesture I choose to interpret as an apology. Then I continue. I decided to make myself useful. I take a deep breath and try to untangle all my thoughts before continuing. I remember that Sarah had taken the book from your mom's shelf and I went to get it back. And look! I hold up the picture I took off the wall. The painting is a little smudged by my nose pressing against it, but it's only a little. Look at that hand! She grabs it. Where did you get this? From over Danny's bed. He must have made it after reading the story. She leans in so close her nose comes away with a spot of blue too. And what do you think well dweller means? I still haven't gotten up to the W's in my dictionary yet. When she looks at me, her eyes are shining. Bob, I don't think it's in the dictionary, but this is it. The final clue we were looking for. You came out of Gran's well. You did. Rufus fell in, and I fell in, and you were there to save us. I frown. But I don't feel like I came from a well, and visiting it yesterday didn't bring back any memories. I know, but maybe that's part of how your magic protects you or something. Protects me by making me forget where I came from? What kind of second-rate magic is that? It's not the best, Livy agrees. I bet the book would tell us more. Yes, let's go ask Danny where it is. She frowns. No one is sure where Danny is right now. I should have told you that right away. That's why Gran took me. There's a big search for him. That would explain what all the commotion and policemen. What are we waiting for then? Let's go find him. I know, I'm trying. She turns back to the painting. Maybe we could use this painting as a map. He could be at the well very well right now. Look, there's a weird tree near it like this. She holds out her arms and makes them all crooked and tilts her head. And there's a creek bed leading up to it, just like the one we're standing on. I look down. The dirt-filled creek is only about an inch or two lower than the ground on either side of it. We've been using it like a path to the trees. Livy, if neither of us pass the tree on our way here, it has to still be up ahead. We take off running along the path, heading deeper and deeper into the bush. Livy continues blowing that awful whistle every 2 minutes, making me jump even though I know it's coming. Gran's responses are getting fainter as we get farther away. We'll have to find the well soon, or else get back before Gran gets too worried and people start searching for us. We step over broken twigs and bits of bark, and I'm glad my feet are thick. Seed pods keep cracking and making us jump, thinking it's the sound of a fire starting. Finally, we stumble into a small clearing, and Livy grabs my arm and points. It's the weird tree! She's right! And behind the tree, almost completely hidden by its long, oddly shaped branches and surprisingly green leaves, is a large brick well. My heart thumps with anticipation. The first thing that we notice as we approach is the complete lack of a green hand gripping the edge of the wall, or any signs of any hands at all. Or any signs of any hands at all, green or Danny-sized. My shoulders sag. Were we wrong about everything? Was the drawing just a picture Danny made when he was bored? She shuffles one way around the well, and I go to the other. At the same time, we shout, Danny! Because there he is. Here he is, leaning against the back of the well, the missing book open on his lap. He sees us and points to a cardboard box on the ground beside him. No one came to take him.
Take it.
No one came to take it, sorry.
My mom's good at reading. Yay.